Jack Anderson.
Well, Murray Chotiner was Richard Nixon's manager in that campaign. As the manager, he came up with a number of the ideas. Probably the most controversial idea was the pink sheet. This was Helen Gahagan Douglas's record in Congress printed on a pink piece of paper. The implication that people got from that was that she was pro-communist.
Nixon was trying to leave the impression that somehow Helen was soft on communism, if not a communist, or a subversive, and that we were fighting communists in Korea, and somehow Helen was significantly responsible for the deaths or the injuries that the American fighting men were sustaining and suffering in the Korean conflict. Throughout his entire political career, Nixon has almost without exception supported a position that advanced the interests of the very, very well-to-do, the most powerful of the economic interests in this country. I don't think he's done this because somehow they put in the fix. And I don't think that's important. I don't know if he really believes what he's been doing, but he's been very consistent about doing it. The fact of the matter is that he's carried the mail for them. And the further fact of the matter is that they recognize it and have contributed substantially to any campaign that he's personally been involved in.
Haven't we got a wonderful candidate for the presidency of the United States?
I'm Jimmy Wexler. I'm now editorial page editor and columnist for the Post. In 52, I was in charge of the news department of the paper at the time the story came in. It was filed by our West Coast correspondent, Leo Katcher, and it seemed to be quite a big story, although I don't really think we anticipated what its repercussions would be. In fact, I can remember now, sort of whimsically, that instead of making it what we call the wood, the big page one head, we had a line on top of page one, which I think read something like, "Reveal Nixon Fun." And it blew up very fast, of course, and the essence of the story simply was that there was a group of industrially financial people, real estate and other special oil interests in California, who provided what I guess we referred to editorially as a fund for the care and feeding of Richard Nixon.